Within the Blackbird Cafe on the counter stands actor Brandon Lee, as per the movie The Crow. Here is an excerpt.
People once believed that when someone dies, a crow carries their soul to the land of the dead. But sometimes, just sometimes, the crow can bring that soul back to put the wrong things right.
Son of Bruce Lee, Brandon Lee was supposedly accidentally shot during the filming of The Crow and died. The crow can symbolize bad omens, problems, conflict and death, among other aspects. In a synchromystical manner, there is a skull depicted on the counter with Lee at the Blackbird Cafe, Darling Harbour. Now, bear with me. The dove is widely known as a symbol of peace. Mark Passio refers to the dove symbolizing the sacred feminine, the positive aspects of the goddess symbolism, emotional aspects, nurturing, care, creativity, truth, getting in touch and owning the repercussions of your actions on other people. The owl, on the other hand, according to Passio, can represent dark care. At Bohemian Grove, occultists perform a ritual titled the cremation of care and do this in front of Moloch, a large owl, where they perhaps, in their minds, disown the repercussions of their actions on other people. In a similar fashion, the owl at Washington DC, Passio asserts, is devouring the feminine, the dome, the breast, with the goddess atop it. Now, whilst other names may be attributed to this goddess statue, for argument's sake, let's just call it the goddess Columbia. Dove in French is Colombe. The dove represents the divine feminine, and therefore care. The owl has swooped, wings outstretched, and symbolically devoured the dove, which is perhaps in its stomach. The sacred feminine, the notion of care. Care, once again, has been sacrificed, a dark occult tradition. So, just getting back to Darling Harbour, what I'd like to do is show what is perhaps a relationship between the club, the home nightclub here, and this garden here, which is the Waratah Garden. This is the world map here, and there is an obelisk in the center emanating from the North Pole with a ball and then a bird on it, and we're going to have a closer look at this. We'll also have a look at what I'm calling a cosmic clock, which sits within the building right about here. So we'll just have a look at this footage. Here we see what could be described as the cosmological clock. If we look at the detail on here, we can see the summer sunset and the winter sunset. We can also see the spring and autumn sunset line. Coming down now over the northern hemisphere, over the pole, and we see the Vesica Pisces being made. As we come down here, we see the summer sunrise line and the winter sunrise line, and the spring and autumn sunrise going through the middle. Also on this, towards the inside, we can read the path of vernal and autumn equinoctial sun. In the middle here, we can see point of home. We have light and dark on this clock. On this side is the light without the stars. And on this side we have the stars representing the night. So we have the night, nighttime, and the daytime.
on each side of the clock.
So I just want to point out something I think is interesting, and that is that we have the home nightclub here with the Vesica Pisces shape, and we have the point of home right here within this Vesica Pisces shape on this cosmic clock. Well, that's what I'm calling it. Now, this cosmic clock shares this world map design with this part here, which is this here. It's blown up here. And we have the pole emanating out of the North Pole with the ball and the bird on top. I talked to Santos Bonacci about this. I only showed him a few images, to be fair. I'll show some extra images after we listen to what Santos Bonacci has to say.
Well, this would be the world, you see, and the world tree. There's always a shaft that goes through. It's like an axis. And, of course, at the top of this obelisk that's in the water, again, you see the feminine and the masculine, the male penetrating the feminine world. But it's pointing to the north, as you say there, and there's a bird on top of this obelisk. Well, in the northern dome of the northern skies, there is Cygnus. And usually you'll find that the Saturnian cult and these people, they're always pointing to either Orion or Cygnus or Draco up in the northern stars. So this would be pointing to the northern stars, telling you what's there. There it is.
So I'd like to thank Santos Bonacci for his thoughts regarding the symbolism here. We'll just go through some extra images, though, that I didn't have a chance to show Santos. We have Zeus here, and he's looking across at an eagle or phoenix on a pillar or a pole. And moving forward, we have a similar, we have a motif here with the ball, the pole, the eagle or phoenix on both sides. There are actually birds up here, too. We'll just keep moving through. This is in Canberra, and we have the Australian-American Memorial, and we have the eagle or phoenix up here, the ball, the phallic pole, and there's actually water around the base here, the female waters in Canberra. This is an old illustration. This is within a church, the same motif. This is more of a decorative motif once again. Now, this is a sort of a patch or a badge, a logo type thing from the German Neumayer Station in Antarctica. So we have the South Pole right here, the Neumayer Station's right there. Interestingly, the pole emanates out of the South Pole, and right at the top here, again, we have the bird motif, in this case a penguin. Interestingly, here we have this magnifying glass with these pyramidal shapes, which are perhaps tents, but who knows, it could be a reference to Egypt. It's quite strange looking, quite uncanny the way it looks. Here are some badges. This is the South Pole there and there. Interestingly, we have another pyramidal tent there. Not sure about that at all, but it's worth pointing out, I think. So there are actually two South Poles at the South Pole. This is more of a sort of a monumental one that sort of stays in the same place. It's actually not on the South Pole because it has been drifting for years and years. But each year a new sort of pole gets put on the South Pole. Because the ice sheet is moving over the South Pole. So this is the home nightclub, and I just want to point a couple of things out. We have the trees here, which perhaps tie in with the notion Santos brought up about the world tree. And there's another aspect I would like to point out on the wall here. And that is that we have this square configuration here on the wall. That is the magic square of Saturn. And I'm pretty sure that this is no accident, that this has been put onto the wall here. So, quite interesting. So we'll just keep moving forward. There are further trees around here. I think there are 6 trees in total on the side of the home nightclub. Quite a curious motif. And I'll just finish up by sort of having a bit of a rant here and talking about things. So we have the pole, these poles coming out of the poles, perhaps, as per at Darling Harbour there. Now, this is perhaps also, they're also perhaps positioned there because of the way the Earth's magnetism works. Now, this image I sort of retrieved from NASA's website. And you know, we have these, we have this sort of magnetic currents, these magnetic paths. So it possibly ties in with that, with this sort of direction in and out, perhaps, of the Earth. The bird motifs also perhaps relate to the path of the spirit. And as Santos is saying, they also perhaps signify the stars above and what lies in the stars above, in the constellations, such as Cygnus. Another factor, considering that Saturnian magic square, these poles could also perhaps relate to pointing towards Saturn, as per the information from the Thunderbolts guys, where they speak about the planets being in a coaxial relationship. In that case, you would have perhaps Mars and Venus and Saturn all in a row in the sky. And perhaps there is an aspect to this, if that perhaps was the case in the past, as per the information from the Thunderbolts crew. Anyway, I think I've sort of spoken enough on this, and I hope you've enjoyed this series and found it interesting, and I'll wind it up from here. So all the best, and thank you.